Okay, let's talk about our last data quality metric, that being uniformity. And we're going to look at how we go about auditing a particular field for uniformity. So if you remember, uniformity is about all the values in a field using the same units of measurement. Let's look at an example. So here we're going to work with the cities data set again. And what I want to explore here is just one field, that being the latitude field. Now the latitude field is identified in this data set using this particular field name. So let's take a look at some of the auditing tasks we might do here. Now the way I've organized this code is that we're going to loop through each of the rows in this data file. And again, here we're using our CSV module in Python. For each row, we're going to call this function audit float field. So this particular piece of code is something that we can actually use to parse any field that should have a floating point value. And in general, this is how I like to think about auditing fields in my data sets. I like to think about the things in general that can go wrong with a particular type of data field and do some auditing for that type. And then if I need to, I can write more specific auditing routines to check the values. Okay, let's take a look at that audit float field function. This is where all of the real work happens here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep track of the number of nulls that I find, the number of empty fields, if any, and then the number of field values that are actually arrays. And if you remember, arrays are encoded using curly braces and vertical bars to separate the individual elements of arrays in the InfoBox dataset. I'm also going to check to make sure that the value is actually a number. And then if it is, I'm going to run a check to make sure that it falls within the minimum and maximum values. Okay, so this is a way of making sure that it's using the units of measurement that I expect. And if you remember earlier, we saw an example where the area for a city is actually represented using square millimeters as opposed to square kilometers. So what I'm doing in this particular piece of code is actually hard coding in some values for this particular field. Now, what I would do here, if I wasn't using this as an example for this course, is I would actually treat each of these as command line parameters that I would input to this script. Here, I'm just going to hard code them in. So if I wanted to actually use this for a different field, what I would do is change the field name and change the min and max values to test for a different float field. Okay, so going back to our audit float field function, again, we're checking for nulls, empties, arrays, any fields that are not in fact a number, once we've made it through all these tests. And then finally, if I get down to here, I've got something that I believe to be a number. What I'm going to do is actually convert it to a floating point value, because of course all the values coming in are strings, and then I'm going to check its range. Okay? Now, the range for latitude, the way this data should be encoded, is between negative 90 and positive 90. And technically speaking, I should have actually made this less than or equal to. Okay, so let's run this and see what pops up. Okay, so I found three non-numbers, and you can see this looks like an okay latitude value, just expressed in a different type of units. Total number of cities, that's what I expect. Quite a few nulls, actually. Okay, not much we're going to do about that in this particular example. And quite a few arrays. If I wanted to fully audit this, I would need to take a look at these arrays and see what's going on there, and then I would need to check each of the individual values in those arrays. What I'm more concerned about in this particular example are these. Now, there are several different ways of representing geographic coordinates. This is three examples where, instead of having the raw values for latitude and longitude, we've instead got this type of coordinate, which is actually degrees, minutes, and seconds. So a different way of encoding the same information for latitude. If I change this code slightly, we'll get a chance to see what the bulk of the values actually look like. Okay. And you can see that they are all values between negative 90 and positive 90. And there we can see a few negative values as well. So commenting those out, running this again, what's going on with these values? Well, the story could be that these numbers were coded by hand using a different coordinate system, and that's actually why we're seeing this come out rather than this type of number, which is what we expect. So this is the type of thing we might see when we're auditing for uniformity. We've got a single field that holds a particular type of data, in this case, latitude values for the location of cities. But there's two different coordinate systems being used here. The decimal degrees latitude, and latitude represented in degrees, minutes, and seconds. Now, in the interest of full disclosure, I actually made the data set dirty by introducing these three values. But this is exactly the type of thing you might expect to see in terms of the same type of value being represented using different units.